Hi everyone, in this video I want to show you how to set up a Wi-Fi range extender so to extend your home Wi-Fi network. In my example, I'll be using the Tenda A23 Wi-Fi range extender. This is Wi-Fi 6 AX1500, but the instructions I'm gonna show you apply also to other Tenda Wi-Fi extenders. And also, other brands of Wi-Fi range extenders will have the same instructions. All you have to do is to get the URL that you need to go to the Wi-Fi extender once you want to set it up, and all the other settings will apply. So what you need to do this is, of course, the device that I just showed you, that is the Wi-Fi range extender, and you need a PC. It can be a Windows PC, it can be also a Mac computer, a Linux computer, any PC that has a web browser will do. So let's start first by powering up the Wi-Fi extender, and I'm gonna show you all the steps to configure it. The first thing you need to do is to power up the Wi-Fi extender. So plug it in any power port and give it a minute to start up. And then if the Wi-Fi extender was used before, you need to reset it. So take a paper clip, and then here on the side, it has a small reset button. So just insert the paper clip in the reset button for 5 seconds and push in. And the green light will light up red. And now you can release it and wait for the extender to start up once again. After you power up and reset the Wi-Fi extender, you need to connect your computer to the default network that this Wi-Fi extender creates. So it is Tenda_ext, and here I'm using a Windows 11 computer. So I'm gonna click on the network icon on the bottom right corner of my PC. Of course, do the same on your computer, whether it is a Mac or Linux. So click on the network icon and then click on the Wi-Fi networks. And this is the default Wi-Fi network. So click on it and then click on connect. So once you are connected, it will open the web browser by default. You need to go to this website, re.tenda.cn. So put in re.tenda.cn and then hit enter. And this is the configuration page of this Wi-Fi extender. So click on start now. The first thing it will ask you is to create a login password. So if you want to manage this device in the future, so here put a strong password and then confirm the password and then click on next. And the extender will go and scan all the Wi-Fi networks in your area. So here you need to choose first the 2.4 gigahertz network that you want to extend. And then later we're going to choose the 5 gigahertz network that we want to extend. So in my case here, I want to extend this network. So select it here and then put the password for this network. So this is a password that you use to connect to this network. And then click on next. And now it will take you to the 5 gigahertz bands. And here choose also the band that you want to extend. So here in my case, I want to extend this band and put the password also for this band. And then click on next. And on this page, it will propose to you the extended Wi-Fi name. So for the 2.4 gigahertz band, it added _ext, and the 5 gigahertz band also it added _ext. And this is fine by me. So I'm gonna leave the name as it is. And here you have the choice or to put a new password for the extended network or use the password from these Wi-Fi networks that we have put previously. So if you want to use the same password, you have to select this checkbox, same as a superior Wi-Fi password. And this is what I want here. So I'm going to use the same password of my Wi-Fi network that I want to extend. And here, click on next. And it will tell you that the LED light will turn green when the network is correctly extended. So let's click on extend. And here, wait for it to finish the configuration. So now the Wi-Fi extension is finished, and notice that the Wi-Fi extender LED light turned to solid green. It means that the setup is correctly done. So now we need to connect to the newly created networks. So here I'm going to click on the network icon once again, and then click on Wi-Fi networks. And I'm going to choose one of the networks that we extended. So I'm going to choose this one, which is 5 extended. And then I'm going to click on connect. And I'm going to put the password to connect to this network. And remember, the password is the same that is on the original network that we extended. This is how we chose it when we did the setup. And now click on next. And now we are connected. And notice when we are connected that the re.tenda.cn website automatically finished the setup. So now I'm going to click on OK here. And I'm going to log in to the extender with the password that we have put for it. So this is the management password. It is not the Wi-Fi password. And here you notice that everything is working okay. This first stage of the setup is finished. Now you can go and use your Wi-Fi extender. But here I'm going to show you a little bit of advanced settings. So the first setting that I want you to change is under Wi-Fi setting. And here you need to change the WPA2 PSK and change it to WPA3 PSK. But careful when you change it, not all devices are compatible with WPA3 security. So if you had problems, come back and change it back to WPA2. So here under 5 GHz, I'm going to change it to WPA3. And unfortunately, we cannot change it under the 2.4 GHz bandwidths. So this is it, WPA2. This is the higher level security that we have on this Tenda Wi-Fi extender. So now I'm going to click on save and the setting is saved. The second thing I wanted to show you under the management of this Tenda A23 extender is the working mode. And this Wi-Fi extender from Tenda has two working modes. So we configured this mode, which is the extender mode. And you'll notice that this is the device and it connects to our main router wirelessly. If you want to convert it to an access point mode, you can connect it with a wire to your main router. But this is not the purpose of this video. But this is good to know that you can also configure it this way. So let's go now to more. And under more, you have OFDMA and it is disabled by default. So enable it here. It will give you better bandwidths. So it is saved. And you have the LED indicator on the extender. So if you're putting the extender like in a dark room and you don't want the LED light to be on all the time, you can either disable it or schedule it to disable at night. I don't want to do this now. You can change your login password. And also you can synchronize your system time if you want. Here it is correct. And I have the GMT is correct also. And under system settings, in case you want to reboot it, reset it, export the system log, or upgrade the firmware, you can do it here. And that is it for the management of this Wi-Fi extender. So now to use the extended network on any device, for instance, on this Windows device, you go to network and then you connect to the extended network. So here it is this one. So make sure you connect to it. And for instance, if you connect your phone to this extended network and to your main network, and when your phone falls out of the range of the main network, it will connect automatically to the extended network. By the way, if you want to check out this Wi-Fi extender from Tenda, I'm going to leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you. And also, if you want to see how this Wi-Fi range extender performs, I have previously made a video and I have measured its performance against a router from Tenda also. So you can check out this video in the description below. I hope that this video was useful to you. In case it was, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I want to thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.